Hi everybody, my name's Isla, welcome to podcast number 10, all new things and a bit about Yarndale. I'm trying something different today with the recording, so I hope it's okay, only time will tell I suppose. It's really foggy outside, it's really dark, it's grey, it's horrible, so I've had to put the light on, so again, we'll see how we get on. But anyway, thank you so much for tuning in and for watching. Welcome if this is your first one. This is only my third proper podcast, so again, I'm all new and learning myself. So if anybody's got any feedback, that'd be great. But first of all, yeah, my name's Isla. I run the online yarn shop called BritYarn. BritYarn specialises in only selling wool that has been 100% grown in Britain. You can find us at www.britYarn.co.uk. We're also on Twitter, Instagram, Ravelry, all as BritYarn. You can subscribe to this YouTube channel, also called BritYarn, and we're on Periscope as well. Today then, we're going to be talking a little bit about the new yarn West Yorkshire Spinners has just fetched out a few weeks ago, called Illustrious, and their pattern book. We'll talk about another new book by Louise Zass-Bangham called Knit, Play, Colour. You have to look at my notes there because I always want to get Knit, Play, Colour the other way around. So, we'll talk about the KAL, our Great British Socks KAL that started today. Obviously, it was the end of the Scollay Along last week. Got a finish object, a few What's in the Jam Pans, and a bit of a Yarndale roundup. And, not forgetting, we've got the Blacker birthday prize draw to do as well. So, we'll get cracking. So, first of all, West Yorkshire Spinners launched a brand new DK weight yarn a few weeks ago. Those of you that follow me on Periscope might have caught my scope last week when I quickly talked about it. But, it's here to my... pointing this out. I'm hoping this is going to work as well the right way round, so fingers crossed you're not going to be looking at things backwards. I know last time I seemed to have fixed it, but it's like I said, I'm using something new this time. So the new yarn is called Illustrious, it's very nice. It's a blend of 70% Falklands wool and 30% British alpaca. And like I mentioned on the Periscope, Falklands wool, it's not a breed of wool, it's just wool that's been sourced in general from the Falkland Islands, so it could be all sorts. But the Falklands wool tends to be merino, corridel, crossy type sheep, so it's really soft yarn. So there's 13 colours, there are two, I shall show you, again I hope these will appear correctly. So there's two which I would class as like a heathered shades, and I think they're really, really quite pretty. So I'm trying to get my angles right on the computer. So there's those, and then they are 11 solid shades. I won't show you them all, but I will just try and show you a selection without chucking them on the floor. Now all the shades have been designed to complement and work together. So you've obviously got the solids. You sort of see what I'm... Oops. Oh dear. Oh no, there we go. You can tell I'm still getting used to all this. So they're all designed to kind of work together. Particularly like this shade. So I am reaching across and I've got a very rockety chair. Particularly like that shade. But yeah, have a look at them on the website. There's sort of pinks, there's purples, there's a really nice green, there's a sandstone, there's one called sea glass, which I really like because I collect sea glass, so I think this is quite nice. So yeah, so as you can see, it is there's not that much halo. It's ridiculously soft. It's machine washable, so it would make it perfect for, I suppose, baby knits, maybe a really nice cosy baby blanket, and also garments and accessories. It really is really, really, really nice. It's $10.95 a ball of 100 gram balls, and you get, bear with me 2 seconds, 225 metres or 245 yards per ball, so there's quite a bit there. So I've knitted up a little test swatch. It's not a very big one. But you can see it's got really nice stitch definition, which would make it great for it's a bit out of focus, which would make it great for cables, anything like that. I've not done a lacy swatch yet, but I also think it would be really nice for lace. But that's that. And I am actually knitting with it at the moment. Those of you that saw me at Yarndale on Saturday, some of you had a squish and saw the mittens that I am making out of that. So that is the yarn. I really recommend it. I think it's a really good addition to the range that West Yorkshire Spinners do. They've obviously got their Air Valley, DK and Aran yarns, which I would class as like your workhorse yarns, you know, there. And they've got a bit of nylon in them, so they're a bit tough. They've obviously got their BFL range, the signature sock range, and the Jacobs. So I think this is a really nice addition to what they've got already. So yeah, go check it out. Definitely recommend it. Excuse me. Coinciding with the launch of the new yarn, they have got a new pattern book which accompanies it. And this is done by a lady called Emma Wright, who is based in Sheffield. So she's a Yorkshire lady. I'm not sure if she's Yorkshire by birth, but anyway. But she's designed this book. And I did show this book on the Periscope. So I'll sort of try not to go over too much old ground. But I'll quickly show you some of my favourite patterns. Now, what I really liked about this, I like the fact that it was spiral bound, because that means you can just lay it flat, you know, when you're working. I also liked the fact of just how it was designed. So this is one of the garments that I like. This is Elizabeth. I thought this was a really nice stylish jumper. And what I really liked is I just liked sort of the little tape features. And just a little, just different. That's my paperclip, obviously, but they've got their own, I'm doing this backwards, they've got their own sort of printed paperclips and stuff. I also like the little pictures that's been included. I think from what I understand, these are the sketches that Emma presented to West Yorkshire Spinners, you know, when she sort of gave them her ideas. So I really like that. I'll just show you some of the other favourite things in here. I've just marked a few. This is another cardigan. It's called Cecilia. This is in the antique gold shade that I showed you. Now, I really like this because from the front, that just looks like a nice, stylish cardigan. But I particularly liked the back detail. So that was really cool. And obviously the neck at the top. Oops. No, here we are. There we are. The neck at the top I thought was pretty different. And then, yeah. What was that? That's Hermione. And I think what I really like about this is that the actual arms are done in, I think it was this shade, if I remember. I'm not doing very well today. I was done in that. But because of how the colours all kind of work together, you could quite confidently, I think, alter it if those shades weren't quite for you. Perhaps using the pinky purpley with the arms instead and, you know, mixing it up a little bit. So that was that one. That was a really nice dress. You don't often see dresses in knitted patterns. Although I did notice, I think it was today on the Ravelry homepage, they've got loads of knitted dresses, if that is your thing. And then finally, they're the gloves that I'm currently knitting. That's Isabella. But I'm just, like I said, I'm just going to knit the gloves, just for the time being. So yeah, so and there's plenty of space for your own notes if you want to sort of scribble. I'm just sort of trying to flick through to show you some notes. Yeah, there's kind of like notes, sections and stuff. So yeah, so both the book and the yarn are on the website. Definitely sort of have a look at those. Put that down there. So the second new thing, this came online, it was yesterday, is Knit Play Colour by Louise Zass-Bangham of Inspiration Knits. You probably know her maybe if you've been to any yarn festivals. She designed the Knit Me and Knit Nights and Simple Shore designs. This book is just fab. Basically, it's just different. It's fab, it's different, it's great. The way Louise has done it is she's obviously designed, it's all shawls and accessories, shawls and cowls, should I say. And there's also a blanket in there as well. But how she's done it, she's not just kind of gone, you know, yes, you need, I don't know, one skein for 400 metres of 4-ply. She's sort of said, well, okay, you can do it in 4-ply, but then if you had X amount of this, then it will look like this, or you can chop and change and you can maybe alter the gauge, or you can block it, you can not block it. And she's actually shown and given examples in every single pattern of how you can alter it. And you don't, I don't think I've ever seen that before to that extent, in terms of, you know, look, literally just rummaging your stash and pull out a couple of skeins and see where you go. So I think that's quite good. And basically, the information on the back is, would you like to find a pattern for that special yarn? Do you want to have fun with texture and colour? Are you looking for projects that are enjoyable to knit? So included with every pattern are ideas and tips on how to play with colour, yarn choices, gauge and finish size. Make each project truly yours. Beautifully photographed, each pattern is illustrated with several examples of the different directions you could take. The flexibility of the patterns means it's easy to find a yarn you'd love to use. This is a perfect go-to book for impulse buys and, more importantly, stash busting. Just great, brilliant. So again, I've picked out a few of my favourites for you. So the first one is called Yarn Tamer. Get my great big fingers out of the way. And Louise is actually hosting her own KAL at the moment in her Ravelry group Inspiration Knits to do the Yarn Tamer. So if you fancy doing a shawl and busting some stash, then check out Louise's Ravelry group. The next one I particularly liked, especially for the winter, is Shadow Lines. Now again, with this shawl, well, it's more of a wrap. It's done in, I think it was a chunky Aran or worsted. And Louise has actually suggested one of the yarns you could potentially use was West Yorkshire Spinners, Blueface Leicester, Aran Weight, which obviously we stock. And so that's quite good, because as you can see, you know, she does give examples of, you know, how you can change things and, you know, like I say, have a look what you've got in your stash and see where you go. And then the final one I particularly liked was called Flight of Colour. Again, I just thought that was a nice way to use up a few different skeins of yarn. And again, she's shown it in different colours and stuff. There we go, it's probably a better picture. I'm just trying to show off the whole pattern. So there we are. So yeah, so definitely recommend checking out that book. Right, what's next? So, so today is the 1st of October, or Socktober, as I quite a lot of our sock fans like to know it as. And if you've been following me on Ravelry, Twitter, Instagram, you'll also know today is the cast on day for the Great British Socks Away KAL. So if you're not signed up yet, it's not too late. Get yourself over there, get yourself signed up. The rules are dead easy, straightforward, and over the next couple of days, we'll start to see some socks appearing, hopefully. So we've got some really amazing prizes. Obviously this is my first kind of solo KAL. So, got my own sort of little things and ideas for prizes. But we've had some really awesome prizes donated, which I haven't asked for. People just got in touch and said, would like to donate. So we've got some prizes, we've got some yarn prizes that have been donated, and they've both been donated by brand new independent dyers. So I won't go into too much detail now because I'm going to do a blog post and stuff on it, and it will be in the Ravelry group. But Phileas Yarns is run by Sylvie, and Patina Yarns is run by Katrina, and they've both donated some of their hand-dyed yarn for prizes. We've got pattern prizes, we've got more yarny prizes, I've got some BritYarn yarny prizes, and there's also a special prize. Joeli from Joeli's Kitchen has very kindly donated a copy of her book, Tiny Treads, and basically the prize, we'll draw the prize for that out of anybody who knits socks for children. So that'll be done separately, as a separate prize draw. So the last up in the news, there seems to be lots of news and stuff today, I'm sorry, I'm waffling on a bit. Obviously the Scollay Along finished last Friday. So that was a bit sad in a way. But you know, I suppose all cameras have to come to an end. So me and Louise will be drawing prizes. I think we've agreed next week we're gonna have a bit of a FaceTime chat and we're gonna kind of do it live, our own prize picks, and then obviously then the random draw, I think, as well. So keep your eyes peeled for that sometime in the next week or so. So I have to drink my tea. My tea today, I'm actually drinking. Louise from KnitBritish did a hot drink and recipe swap, and I swapped with a lady in Denmark. And so this tea is from her. So she gave me a selection of teas and some coffee, which I've not had yet. But this is Choco Chai Tea Time. It's nice. I like tea. So, what's next? FOs. I have been desperately trying to finish these socks. Readiness to start, obviously, the sock cal. So these are my show-off socks by Anne Campbell in yarn from New Zealand, I'm afraid. But we all have a stash history. But yeah, I actually think it's a really great pattern, to be fair. I think if you've got any yarn in your stash that you're wanting to bust, then as well as obviously the Knit Play colour book, this is a great pattern on Ravelry, and it's a free pattern as well. Really simple, dead easy, really interesting heel construction as well. So yeah, check them out. So what's in the Jam Pan? I have been trying to, I suppose, not really sort of clear, but just try and keep things down. So new, obviously casting on for the Socks KAL today. I didn't tell you actually what I was casting on for my socks. After much deliberating, I'm going to cast on, I'm not going to be able to spell it very well, phalanges, I think that is. I'm rubbish at putting on things. But I'm using, it's not that colour at all, it's a really rubbish how it's displayed. But this is West Yorkshire Spinner's Signature 4-ply in the Blueberry Bonbon, I do believe it was. I've not got a full skein here because I used this this colour to do the heels and toes of my Rothweight socks. So I think there's about 80-ish grams. But they're toe-up socks, so it should be fine. They might have to be a little shorter. But they're like a lacy sock. So that's my Great British Socks Away KAL socks. So, where was I? So, yeah, so obviously I've been trying to, just kind of keep things manageable because I really do want to, obviously, take part in my own KAL and finish it would be quite nice, quite finish the socks. So, current WIPs, like I say, many of you have seen these. These are my, obviously not got very far, I get the cables out here. Out your face. So these are going to be the Isabella socks that I am. Isabella socks? I'm not with it. Isabella mitts, fingerless mitts that I showed you from Emma Wright's pattern book for the Illustrious. So, and they're quite long ones. So I've literally just got to the end of the ribbing for the cuff and then it's sort of cables and bobbles. And what I'm going to do, thanks to a tutorial that Joeli has done, Joeli's Kitchen, she's done a little tutorial about cabling with that cable needle. And that's what I'm up to next. And by coincidence, not really coincidence, but again, I'm just cast on hats in some Jacob Aran, West Yorkshire Spinners Jacob Aran, and that's also got cables without a cable needle. So by the end of these gloves and my hat that I'll show you in a second, I should have cracked cabling without a cable needle. Two chances. So other whips, I have been doing a little bit of work on my Talavera. Again, it's lace, so it just looks shocking, doesn't it, until you've blocked it. If you can see, so this is the one that was in Pom Pom, Summer's Pom Pom. It's just like a lacy t-shirt. Like I say, that looks, as all lace does, pretty shocking until you've blocked it. So, but that's going quite nicely. And then, oh, I should say, the Talavera is by Amanda Collins, our Print Panda, on Twitter and Instagram. Next is the Mahy KAL by Mahy KAL. No, that's the KAL I'm doing. Mahy Hap by Karie Westermann. So I have finished all of the in the triangle, and I'm a few rows off from finishing chart A. And this is really enjoying this actually. It's all charted, it's my first pattern that I've done that has been all charts. But yeah, so far so good. I've discovered the wonders of washi tape for doing charts, so if you're a bit scared of charts and think, oh gosh, don't want to do them, definitely buy some washi tape, because I've done a little bit of charted work before and really struggled just trying to keep my place, and I've bought some, and yeah, it's going really well. So yeah, just a few more rows from doing charts, the first chart. And I'll show you these little stitch markers, I think I showed you them before, are from Little Grey Girl. She's on Twitter and Instagram. So yeah, really loving this. It's a really nice design. Carrie keeps on bringing out great designs. She has recently launched a shawl. She's doing a collection, and I should have checked how you pronounce this, and I'm really sorry, Carrie, because I haven't checked. But it's Higgy. It's like a Danish concept of sort of good living and comfortable and social stuff. So she recently launched the shawl called Fika, which I really like, want to cast on. And in a book that I bought at Yarndale, she's also got another shawl pattern on there. So she just keeps doing these amazing patterns, and I can't keep up. But yeah, really enjoying this. And this is in Lincoln Longwool that I bought at the Lincolnshire Show. So yeah, it's pretty fab. Really definitely enjoying that. Let me just put my stitch markers back on before I drop all my stitches. And then you would hear me cry. Somewhere here. There we go. Yeah, I don't fancy dropping. It's really good. The yarns are really sticky actually. It's a proper, so I don't think there'd be no much chance of dropping too many there, but put that away. And then last up is something I cast on a couple of days ago, is the Lexi Hat by Woolly Wormhead. Again, it's another pattern on Ravelry. And this is in West Yorkshire Spinners Jacob Aran, which BritYarn stocks. There's been some really nice cardigans knitted recently in the Jacob. It's a very much, I don't know, it's an undervalued yarn. I think it's great, brilliant value for money. It's not as soft as Blueface Leicester, but it's, yeah, I could wear it, and quite a few people on Ravelry that have recently bought Jacob from me have knitted cardigans and are loving it as well. So this hat, Lexi, is knitted slightly differently from other hats. You kind of knit a moss stitch strip, and then you pick up and then go upwards. It's also a really good pattern because you need to have a couple of really big buttons, and I've got a few big buttons in my stash that I've bought from various places, so it's quite good to sort of be able to use those type of things. But yeah, loving it so far. Great stitch definition from the Jacob. Little bit of a halo there. It's interesting actually, because obviously Jacob is a multicoloured sheep, and this is the ecru version. And this hasn't got that much sort of doesn't have that much of the longer fibres in it, but the darker shades, I'll reach across, excuse me. But the darker shades, you can see they're a little bit more woolly. I don't know if you can make that out, you might not be able to. But I think it's just because of the slightly paler fibres, slightly more visible. I think that's what it is. But yeah, I would definitely check it out. You know, if you're wanting something just to have a bit of a play with, to try something different apart from, you know, your normal blue face Leicesters and such like, try it out. Buy a ball for a hat. See how you get on. But yeah, enjoying that. So I think that is all my WIPs, what's in my jam pan at the moment. Like I said, I'm still working on shawl Viella by Clare Devine in some yarn that we'll be stocking at some point in the future. And I just pick that up now and again and work on it. So, right, next up then is Cornish Tin. Those of you that bought Cornish Tin, congratulations, well done. It flew off the shelves on that Friday morning. I think it was it the 14th it launched? And I woke up and looked at my phone and thought, best get busy. It was amazing. We sold out of how many shades? Probably over half of the shades. We sold out of two. We sold out of the grey and the turquoise by like, I don't know, mid morning, if that's. We've now got none left. I think we had a little bit of DK in the green left, and that sold over the weekend. But it sold out everywhere. It's been so popular. I think Blacker were just a little bit overwhelmed actually by how popular it was. I'm really looking forward to seeing what you make with it all. I know there's a few people planning to make socks in the KAL, BritYarn KAL with it. I've seen Louise Toolbrook, she's been plotting a shawl with it. Really excited to see what you all make with those. Now, in the tin. We at the start of September launched a Blacker Yarns birthday giveaway. And for everybody who bought two or more balls of Blacker Yarns, not including Cornish Tin, throughout the month of September got put in the prize draw. And the prize draw was to win a skein of Cornish Tin 4-ply and a BritYarn Canvas bag. So I've been putting all the order numbers on a spreadsheet, and then today, I'll show you these, like tipping them out. Today I posted a picture on Instagram and Twitter, and then I've chopped up all the numbers. So I'm probably blinding you here with a tin. I chopped up the numbers and put them in here. So I will draw that one out, and I'll read out what the order number is, and then I will check on, obviously on the website to see who it was, and then I'll drop you an email just to confirm your address details and stuff. So, it's quite new back in this. I should probably do it so you can see what I'm doing. Old fashioned quarter street tin. Right, we've got one. It's order number 364. So I will check who that is and be in touch. And if it's you, shout. Congratulations. Right, let's put the lid back on there. So, so that was that. That's like my first BritYarn giveaway. So finally then, just a bit of a Yarndale roundup, just to finish off, if that's okay. So Yarndale was last weekend, the 26th, was it? Can't remember. 26th and 27th, I think it was September. Yarndale was at Skipton in North Yorkshire. It was really busy. I think I'm going to have to stop going on the Saturday because there was also loads of people I wanted to speak to. I had a bit of a list of kind of like work things I wanted to get done. Obviously, can't do that during the the main part of the day because it's just really busy and obviously everybody's got stores and they're seeing customers and things. So I left it until towards the end of the day when it was a bit quieter, but then ran out of time. So there were loads of people that I couldn't get to see, unfortunately. But I didn't actually buy any yarn. It's the first time I've ever been to a yarn festival and not bought yarn. Sometimes you're just not, I just weren't quite feeling it. You know, there were lots of lovely things, and there were some quite really nice stores that were selling some pure British yarns from their own farms, which I thought was really good. But yeah, I just wasn't feeling it. So my perch, well, no, first of all, then I'll talk about the Scollay meetup, because that was pretty fab, to be fair. Again, if you follow us on BritYarn, Instagram, Ravelry, Twitter, you'll see the pictures that we posted. But at 2 o'clock, we all congregated outside, and all of our scholars. I should have counted, actually. I can't remember how many were there. There were loads of us. Karie Westermann was able to come down from Glasgow to Yarndale, so she came along to the meetup, which was really nice. And it was just brilliant to see just so many scholars all together in real life. It was brilliant to see how some people had slightly altered the design to suit them. So it was an awesome jumper. And that was by Katrina of Patina Yarns. She'd actually converted hers, the pattern, into a jumper, which looked, check it out on the Ravelry FO page, it was really good. It was really nice to see yarn that I'd sold. Obviously I'd wrapped up and it had gone off, and I'd been watching people's progress on the forums. And then to actually see it, obviously squish it and stuff, that was really cool. It was just really, really nice. Kate Heppel, the editor of Knit Now magazine, she got us all arranged in colour order and we had our pictures taken. And they're the pictures that obviously you've seen in various places. So if you was able to get to that, thank you so much for taking time out of your day, out of your shopping time, I suppose, to see you. It was really nice. Also sort of bumped into quite a few other people during the course of the day. Quite a few people recognised me, which is a bit strange. I really appreciate you taking the time to come out, because I know obviously you go to these events and it's about the shopping and it's about sort of obviously, you know, seeing things and meeting people, and it was just, it was nice. And the sun shone, it was actually really quite warm. Quite a few of us are sitting here kind of going, oh, it's so hot. And it was also really cool because quite a few people who wasn't part of the Scollay along came, people that I know from going to other yarn festivals, they came along. It was great to see what your purchases, what you're wearing knitwear wise. Yeah, it was really good. I know Karie, I think, was pretty blown away by seeing everybody there as well. So that was a Scollay along meetup. In terms of purchases, like I said, I didn't really make that many. In terms of stores, all the so it was all your normal expected kind of people were there. So Victoria Eden Cottage Yarns had a really big store there, and she was launching her new pattern book called Drift, which I bought. I'll quickly show you. So this is Drift. It's a collection of patterns. So it's done by different designers, which Victoria has pulled together. It's done in her Whitful alpaca, which is a Peruvian alpaca. So not British, so we don't stock the alpaca. But what I was thinking, if you wanted to do these designs perhaps in something British, then I think the Illustrious from West Yorkshire Spinners would be ideal. And I am already plotting several things, including that cardigan in Illustrious. Like I said, Karie Westermann has another hat pattern in here, which I want to knit. I'm sorry, I'm flicking through this because I really should have page marked and I didn't. Just want to quickly show you. There's a really nice jumper, which has got some nice, called Cloudburst. It's got some nice lacy details. which I really liked. Flick through, yeah, it's hats, there's gloves, there's Louise Tilbrook, the designer of the Rothwaite socks. She's done some very nice fingerless mitts. I've got a bit of a thing at the moment for fingerless mitts, I think. They will have to be cast on at some point. Claire Devine's got a nice hat pattern in here. Louise Zass-Bangham, as Inspiration Knits, has also got a pattern in. So quite a lot of people you'll be familiar with, and then there's some designers in here that I'm not, you know, not necessarily familiar with. There's some crochet patterns, there's a crochet hat, there's a crochet cowl, and there's some crochet mittens. So there's a little bit in there for crochet. This is the hat by Karie Westermann. Now this wool, I am definitely knitting this in Illustrious. This is going to happen at some point, most definitely. But yeah, it's a nice book, I really like it. Claire Devine does the layouts, so it's all really nicely laid out. So that's that. I purchased a coaster. Every year, a company called Tile Productions have a little stall. And every year I try and buy, no, not every year actually, because the first year I couldn't get near their store, so I didn't buy anything. But last year I bought a little Christmas tree decoration, and this year I bought a coaster. So yeah, so that's from Tile Productions. They are actually a pop tile maker, and what they do with their, I suppose, they're not leftover bits, but I suppose it's surplus clay, is they make buttons, they make obviously coasters. Now these are new, so I've not seen these before. They make buttons, they make coasters, they make things like dangly Christmas tree decorations, they make little plaques, all sorts. So I thought I really liked that. I kind of wish I'd bought more, so I'm hoping they keep doing those. So I bought the coaster. I also chatted to Jess from Ginger Twist Studios. Jess has it's really cool actually. It's a tiny, tiny, tiny yarn shop in Edinburgh. If you're ever up in Edinburgh, definitely, definitely check it out. Because she crams in just so much fab stuff. She dyes her own yarn as well, including some British bases. It's not all British, but she does have a nice selection of British bases as well. But Jess and Claire Devine launched their 2016 Neighbourhood Sheep Society. I missed out in 2015, so I had to make sure I was getting on for 2016. And this is basically where Jess and Claire work together. Jess basically researches and gets in some British bases from you know, from small farms. You know, it's not the run-of-the-mill kind of stuff. And she dyes it. Although apparently on one of them there might be some naturals, so that'd be quite exciting. And then Claire designs patterns. And it's a surprise, it's kind of, you don't know what you're going to get. So the first one will be arriving through my door in January. So looking forward to that. And that was it, that was all I bought. I bought the coaster, I bought the Drift Pattern Book, and I subscribed and signed up to the Neighbourhood Sheep Society. So if you're interested in British wool and want a bit of a surprise club type thing, then check out Jess's shop. And yeah, so apart from that, I just, yeah, chatted to quite a few people. Didn't chat to as many people as I wanted to, but I finally met Sonja from Blacker Yarns. We've been chatting on email and on the phone since the start of the year, to be fair. So that was really nice to kind of show her, to show her my Scollay, and to actually put a face with a name. And Blacker are actually holding, they do these, I think they're three times a year. So in October, from the 8th until the 10th, they're doing a pop-up sale and woolen mill tour. So if you're down in Cornwall, then it might be worth checking that out. So yeah, so I chatted with Sonja, so that was really good. She was wearing a really nice cardigan. I think that was in, I think it was their Blacker Swan. DK, and I missed her nails. She's got really fab painted nails with sheep on them, and I missed them because I'm busy looking at her cardigan. chatted and managed to see Louise Zass-Bangham from Inspiration Knits. I really briefly bumped into her when I was at Yarn in the City, but she was busy setting up her pop-up designer stall, and I was obviously volunteering and doing other things, so it was nice to have a bit of time chatting with her and just catching up, and she was telling me about how the book came into being. I finally also met Nick from Yarns from the Plain. Nick dyes our exclusive landmark shades on the Mobley base. So it was really nice to meet Nick. Nick was actually, she didn't have a stall herself, but Nick's actually a student for at Bradford College. So she was on the Bradford College stall sort of stands, exhibiting their textile students' work, including some of Nick's own weaving stuff, which was interesting. And also got to chat again to Joeli from Joeli's Kitchen. I first met Joeli at Leeds Yarn Festival earlier on this year, so it was really good to see Joeli again and catch up. And and obviously I'm going on her retreat in February next year, so that's also all good stuff. So I think the only other thing I wanted to tell you all about was Louise from KnitBritish is launching, is it next week? I think it's on the 5th, a KnitBritish breed swatch along. And this is basically where she's getting people to just knit a swatch with British or local to you yarn, if you're not in Great Britain. Excuse me. And what she's basically wanting people to do is just to sort of just to experiment. A bit like, you know, me, what I've seen with the Jacob. You know, it's not expensive, get a ball, see how you get on with it. So basically there's all the threads are open in her own, in the KnitBritish Ravelry group, so go and check them out. It's literally just a case of, you know, maybe getting a 50 gram ball of 100% pure breed wool. She doesn't want any mixes, and she's produced a really good test drive sheet of just some of the things that she wants people to think about when before they knit, while they're knitting, after they knit, after they've blocked it, once they've worn it against their skin for a little bit. And these are the type of things I do anyway when I'm sort of knitting with yarn to talk to you guys about, I suppose. She's produced quite a lot of really good resources on her blog. She's been breaking down a lot of the wool marketing board material to make it a little bit more easier, so more accessible. So yeah, if you've got something in your stash, maybe you've picked up a ball along your way and think, what on earth do I do with 50 grams, then have a rummage in your stash and see if there's anything that might work, and check out Louise's Ravelry group. So that is definitely it. I'm sure I'm rustling papers, so I apologize. So thank you once again for tuning in. I'm going to upload this to YouTube. It takes forever to do. I have the slowest broadband ever, especially for upload. So I will start the upload process this afternoon, and hopefully it won't take any more than 24 hours to get it up there. Thank you ever so much for listening. Please join in the chat in our Ravelry groups. We've got all sorts of different forum threads there for WIPs, British wool WIPs, FOs, all that type of thing. If you've got any questions, let me know there. Either drop me an email or tweet me, or Instagram me, whatever. And I'll see you around soon. Happy knitting, everyone.